Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see what is Pierce oscillator and what is the frequency of oscillations of Pierce oscillator. So let's begin with the topic. We know that crystal oscillator, when connected in the circuit and when we applied AC signal at the output, it exhibits a property of piezoelectric effect. The variety of crystal oscillator circuits are available in the market, like clap crystal oscillator, then Colpitt crystal oscillator, tune crystal oscillator. But out of this circuit, the Pierce crystal oscillator is most commonly used circuit for practical applications. We know that the crystal oscillator uses quartz material for construction. The quartz material is available in hexagonal shape with pyramid at the top and bottom. Then in order to find out or in order to obtain crystal out of that, we need to cut it rectangularly by using a various cut. Based on the type of cut we are using, there the property of the crystal is get changes. So when we need to use the crystal in the circuit, we need to mount it between the two plates and then the entire packet is get housed in one pack. So when the AC signal is applied across such crystal, it produces mechanical vibrations at the output. Now let's see what Pierce crystal is. So for that we need to consider the diagram. So in the diagram, the symbolical representation of crystal oscillator is represented by XTAL. This is considered as a crystal oscillator and it is connected between feedback path, that is between collector and base of transistor. The resistor R1, R2 forms voltage divider and resistor R1, R2 along with RE provides DC bias to the transistor. The biasing is important because we need to amplify the output. So in order to use transistor as an amplifier, it is very much important to provide biasing. And that biasing is provided by using a voltage divider bias network formed by resistor R1 and R2. The capacitor C is basically used to pass any AC signal and blocks DC signal. There is one coil called as RFC, that nothing but the radio frequency choke, which is basically used to provide DC signal to reach to the collector and is connected between VCC and collector of the transistor. The capacitor C is used as a blocking capacitor which blocks DC component and allows only AC component to pass through the circuit. Now, in case of Pierce crystal oscillator, the frequency of oscillation is given by the formula FO is equal to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L C1. Now here we are considering series resonant frequency that is most commonly used in the applications. In case of series resonant frequency, if we consider the electrical equivalent circuit of crystal oscillator, then the electrical equivalent circuit consists of one branch having series connection of RLC1, which is connected parallelly with the other branch, which consists of only capacitor. So when reactance of inductor is equal to reactance of capacitor C1, then it provides series resonant frequency. So here we are using that formula as a resonant frequency. The frequency at which the maximum vibration occurs is called as resonant frequency. In case of Pierce oscillator, as the frequency is set or provided by the crystal oscillator itself, therefore any variations in the supply voltage, change in the condition of biasing or change in the transistor parameter will not affect the output frequency. That's why the crystal oscillator provides a stabilized and more accurate frequency output. And therefore, because of this reason, the crystal oscillators are used in the applications like communication transceiver, digital watches, clocks or time-based circuit. The range of frequency provided by crystal oscillator varies from 15 kHz to 10 MHz. If the range of frequency increases beyond 10 MHz, then it is not possible to obtain signals at the output of crystal oscillator. The crystal oscillator, instead of using transistor, we can mount it by using FET also, that means field effect transistor. Now here the transistor or FET provides phase shift of 180 degree by amplifying the signal. As the output is taken from collector and the feedback is applied between collector and base through a capacitor C and crystal, therefore it provides a feedback of 180 degree. So the total phase shift around the loop becomes 360 degree or 0 degree, which satisfied the Barkhausen's criteria for oscillations. The advantage of using FET in the circuit over BJT is the FET having high input impedance. Because of that, it reduces loading effect at the input stage. So instead of using BJT, if we use FET, then we will get more stabilized and accurate signal at the output. So this is what about the Pierce crystal oscillator, which is most commonly used oscillator amongst other, which is having frequency as a series resonant frequency, that is fs equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of lc1, in which the reactance of inductor is equal to reactance of c1. So I hope you understand the circuit of Pierce crystal oscillator. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.